You've been told only humans play with fire. But what if a bird, yes, a bird, used fire as a hunting weapon? Here's the part that shocked scientists. Some birds in Australia have figured out how to spread wildfires on purpose. These aren't fantasy creatures, they're real. Black kites, whistling kites, and brown falcons. And they've been caught doing something that was once thought impossible, carrying burning sticks from active wildfires and dropping them on fresh grasslands to start new fires. Why? To force hidden animals out of the bush. Instant barbecue. But how did birds evolve to wield fire like a tool? And what does this mean for the future of wildfires? Stick around, because this story only gets more unbelievable. This is not an isolated myth or tribal tale. It's been documented by firefighters, indigenous rangers, and even scientists. Enter our unlikely arsonist heroes, the Firehawks, a nickname given to these cunning raptors. And their villain? The dry, flammable ecosystem of Northern Australia, where survival demands innovation. The first formal documentation came in 2016. Researchers published findings in the Journal of Ethnobiology, describing over 20 eyewitness accounts, birds picking up smoldering sticks from active fires, flying 50 to 100 feet, and dropping them on untouched brush. Why? To expand the fire line, to create panic, to expose insects, frogs, lizards, and small mammals fleeing the flames, to hunt more effectively. One of the authors, Dr. Mark Bonta, called it purposeful fire propagation, not accidental. And he wasn't alone. Dozens of field officers reported seeing birds working in groups. Yes, groups, like a squad of airborne arsonists spreading flames in coordination. That opens a whole new door. Is this behavior being taught from bird to bird? If so, we're not just talking about instinct. We're talking about culture. But let's think about that for a moment. Can animals teach fire? Tool use among animals isn't rare. Chimps show their young how to use sticks to fish for termites. Crows pass along puzzle-solving tricks. But fire, that's different, that's dangerous. If fire spreading is being copied and passed down, not just triggered by instinct, but refined over time, then we're watching cultural evolution in real time. And that makes these birds not just survivors, but teachers. And what's wild, indigenous Australians have known about this for centuries. They speak of the firehawks, birds who manipulate fire like seasoned predators. But what's even more interesting, fire as a tool isn't unique to humans alone anymore. In the past, fire stick farming was practiced by Aboriginal peoples to hunt kangaroos and wallabies. They would intentionally burn grasslands, then wait with spears as the animals fled. The firehawks are copying this tactic almost perfectly, only they don't need spears. In fact, some researchers believe these birds might have learned the technique by observing humans for generations. Think about that. Birds not only watching, but replicating one of humanity's oldest hunting strategies. It's not just intelligence, it's mimicry. It's legacy. Let's get into how they actually do it. These birds don't wait for luck. They watch the edge of a wildfire. They swoop down, grab a smoldering twig, not fully flaming, but still hot enough. Then they fly off to where the grass is dry and drop the ember. Seconds later, the brush ignites, and suddenly, small animals who once had cover are forced to run. Then the birds do what they've always done best. They swoop, they strike, they feast. Picture it. The dry grass crackling, smoke thick in the air, lizards darting for cover, small mammals zigzagging in panic. And above them, a circle of wings. One bird dives, another follows. They're not fighting for scraps. They're executing a plan. In some cases, researchers noted they don't even eat everything. The hunt might be just as important as the meal, as if controlling fire itself gives these birds dominance in their ecosystem. But here's the crazy part. This isn't just a behavioral quirk. It may be evolutionary. Think about it. These birds may be adapting, to use human-caused fires or natural wildfires as tools. Which begs the question, are we watching the birth of fire-based hunting evolution? Or has it been happening far longer than we ever realized? But there's something even more alarming. Some scientists worry, if birds are learning to intentionally spread fires for survival, could other species follow? Monkeys using tools, crows solving puzzles, now birds weaponizing fire? Humans have used fire for hunting for tens of thousands of years. It's called fire stick farming, clearing grasslands to trap prey. But now nature is flipping the script. What we thought was our tool might be nature's weapon too. And this has conservationists worried, because as climate change dries out more land, these birds could unintentionally become accelerants in wildfire disasters. It's not just a fascinating oddity, it's a potential problem. Imagine if this had happened in ancient times. Birds carrying fire across dry plains, nomadic tribes unaware that it wasn't lightning or weather, but wildlife helping fire jump. Some believe certain unexplained fire patterns in history might actually make more sense if animals were involved. Maybe the idea of fire-bringing creatures in mythology wasn't all metaphor. Maybe, just maybe, nature was already writing that story. If birds can spread fire intentionally, that changes the wildfire risk map. What if this behavior spreads to other continents? Fire-prone areas like California, Portugal, or the Amazon? If even one species learns from another, or migrates, we're looking at new wildfire patterns with intelligence behind them. Could artificial intelligence predict this? Not yet, but perhaps natural intelligence already has. The world is heating up, and fire is no longer our tool alone. Right now, most wildfire models assume passive spread, based on wind, heat, and terrain. But add in an animal that can pick up a spark and drop it miles away, you've got a flying ember generator. And the scariest part? It's hard to track. There's no bird on record saying, "Yeah, I did it." Just the occasional smoldering grass where there shouldn't be fire. What if this isn't just about birds and fire? Before we wrap this up, pause and ask, have we underestimated animal intelligence all along? We gave them instincts, but they've got innovation, and it's catching fire, literally. What if this is about intelligence, adaptation, survival? These birds aren't just reacting, they're strategizing, and that forces us to rethink what animals are capable of. If a bird can learn to hunt with fire, what else might the animal kingdom be learning right under our noses? This is not just about evolution, it's about revolution in behavior. In a world where attention is currency, we just uncovered a bird that uses fire like a weapon, that manipulates nature to flush out prey. So the next time you look up and see a bird circling a wildfire, ask yourself, is it fleeing the flames or feeding the fire? If this blew your mind, share it, because this is one of those stories that deserves to be told around the fire, like literally.